today on 15 on 15.
Prime Minister Ayman, together with his delegation, is moving towards TEDx Aruba. Plus, check out what a bar in Tokyo is doing in an effort to fight against domestic violence. And the Ministry of Justice is in discussion to implement a ban on right-handed steering vehicles.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Yanta Liu. The Prime Minister of Aruba spoke at a TEDx Binnenhof conference earlier this year regarding the island's sustainability vision. The leader, along with his delegation, is now moving forward with TEDx Aruba.
Prime Minister Mike Ayman is a driving force behind initiating the TEDx Aruba platform on the island. He explains why.
We have worked tirelessly toward creating the opportunity that we can present the TEDx platform here in Aruba. It is important for us to have such a platform in Aruba because we have set out to make our island very special in this world. We want an island where our community doesn't only share prosperity, but also shares well-being and happiness. This is a concept of a society that many countries are looking at, but see the difficulty of having an ideal, but having the tools to translate an ideal into reality.
Prime Minister Ayman says TEDx Aruba will do plenty for the island in terms of sharing the accomplishments with the world. It will contribute to the island's sustainability goals.
By creating a platform such as TEDx, we will have a great opportunity to welcome to Aruba the most brilliant thinkers in this world on the concepts that we would like to frame the TEDxes of Aruba in the future. And those concepts will be around a sustainable society, a sustainable society where we can create sustainability in the sense of prosperity, in the sense of well-being, in the sense of happiness for all our citizens, and then translates these concepts into broader concepts that can also be applied for larger countries, larger cities, and for humanity as a whole.
The Prime Minister says Aruba may be small, but it is doing great things. Things worthy of sharing with the rest of the world. With TEDx conferences taking the world by storm, the island should take this into consideration and launch a version of its own.
In a small island as Aruba, with a small community, we could do things that doesn't only affect what we're trying to do in Aruba, but could also affect the course of humanity and the world. And if we can have a small contribution to that, TEDx will definitely give us one platform that will make us closer to creating an international network for our ideals to become reality in Aruba and maybe in the world.
TEDx Aruba is a huge undertaking. On the next 15 on 15, we will hear from other stakeholders who are part of making this platform happen. Moving forward, would you like a little taste of Paris while you are on the island? And once you are visiting this French city, you will also be contributing to a tremendous cause at the end of this month with Kiwanis Circle K, Colegio EPI.
Kiwanis is an organization, it's a nonprofit organization that has as objective vision to serve the children of the world. On Aruba, we have officially 10 Kiwanis clubs consisting of various age groups. We have Circle K clubs, Key clubs, Builders clubs, the Kiwanis clubs, and we of the Circle K of Colegio EPI also has various projects that we do in order to get the funds necessary to do community service. With projects such as the Midnight in Paris Ball.
For Kiwanis Circle K of EPI's next event, it will center around a Paris theme, but with a ton of musical twists.
On the 6th of June 2015, we will have our annual gala event, which will be the Midnight in Paris Ball. This concept is basically for everyone who has never been or has been to Paris to get the feel of Paris during this night. It's going to be a very fabulous night. We have the entertainment, of course, by Enfusion, Bouleria. We're going to have DJ Dannyville, Bam Star. So we have music taste for everyone, and it's going to be a very fabulous night.
The fundraising event takes place on June 6th at the Radisson Ballroom. Tickets are 100 florins each. You can purchase them at Trash, Dress Code, or with any of the Kiwani Circle K members. You can email them, circlek@epiaruba.com, or call them 737-3083. All proceeds will be invested back into the community. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
When we return, epic selfies and much more can be done with this drone named Lily.
Welcome back from the break. You are watching 15 on 15. Alcohol consumption plays a role in domestic violence. In an effort to raise awareness on this, a bar in Tokyo, Japan has taken it upon themselves to do something about it.
Japan is said to be one of the safest countries in the world, but behind closed doors, Japanese women are becoming more vulnerable. Excessive alcohol consumption is fueling a rapid rise of domestic violence. To address the issue, Yacho, a bar in Tokyo, started a socially conscious campaign encouraging responsible drinking. Introducing the Violent Coasters. A series of traditional coasters uses portraits of typical Japanese women have been designed. The coasters are printed in thermochemical technology, so whenever a glass is placed on the coaster, the coldness of the glass will make the ink react, showing cuts and bruises on the woman's face. This way, every time the drinkers raise their glass for a sip, they will see a change and a sentence saying, "Don't let excessive drinking end in domestic violence."
Very interesting indeed. Moving on, have you ever wondered just how far in life being active will get you? Well, we have an exact number for you. Elderly people who exercise live 5 years longer. Researchers say regular exercise in old age has as powerful of an effect on life expectancy as giving up smoking. The analysis of 5,700 elderly men in Norway showed those doing 3 hours of exercise a week lived around 5 years longer than those who didn't. Experts are calling for fitness in older people. In the study, both light and vigorous exercise extended life expectancy. It is recommended for those over 65 to have 150 minutes of moderate exercise per week. Here's another interesting fact. In an analysis of many countries regarding moderate exercise, it shows that the Netherlands is doing relatively well. Only 14% of its people are not partaking in physical activities. Meanwhile, other countries, such as Portugal, has a population of 69% not doing enough exercise and 55% in Poland. And are you ready to take up your selfie game? Lily the drone will sure help you achieve this goal. Check it out.
Meet Lily. All you do is throw her up and go. Whatever extreme activity you are doing, and the drone will capture all the movements in full HD. The battery lasts for about 20 minutes, so it is perfect for capturing extreme sports. You have to keep the tracking device in your pocket, then throw the drone up in the air, and Lily will do all the work for you. It can take stills or even film videos. It also can be waterproof as well, and it captures sounds. When you are done creating an epic selfie video, the Lily Cam will simply land in the palm of your hand. The Lily drone will follow your whereabouts, so you will never have to take a selfie again. Or better yet, it will take even more beautiful selfies of just you or you and your family with an incredible scenic background.
Seems like drones are just about to take over the world, because here on 15 on 15, we've showed you drones as waiters, drones delivering Amazon products, and now this. Very interesting indeed. Let's just wait and see where they take us. We are going to take a very quick break right now. Here is a word from our sponsors.
Ahata is with Minister Dowers on banning cars with a right-handed steering wheel. Find out why coming up.
Making headlines today is the Minister of Justice Arthur Dowers' decision to possibly implement a new law banning right-handed vehicles on Aruba's roads. According to statistics, a high percentage of the vehicles involved in car accidents on the island are cars with a right-hand steer. Ahata is one entity in full support of this.
The perspective of Aruba's Hotel and Tourism Association regarding vehicles with a right-handed steering wheel is simple. Jim Heppel says these types of cars makes the island's roads more dangerous.
It is being quite dangerous because basically what you're saying is that the individual who's driving this car that has the steering wheel on what you might say is the wrong side, because when you say the right side, it sounds as though it's the correct side. No, but it's on the wrong side. Because they don't have good visibility when it comes to overtaking or when it comes to making turns.
Jim Avahata explains how right-handed cars negatively impacts tourism.
The situation is quite dangerous for visitors because clearly, with virtually all of the people who are renting cars coming from overseas, it's really only the Dutch visitor who's comfortable with the road signs. I mean, the American visitor, the Latin visitor, they don't know in many instances what all of our road signs mean. They've got an idea because they're, to a certain extent, they're international signs, but the language for them is unknown.
The signs on Aruba's roads in different languages already makes it confusing for foreign drivers. So with the right-handed vehicles mixed in together adds further anxiety and unfamiliar circumstances to the roads. This leads to higher chances of collision.
And so consequently, they're going to be nervous when they're driving. And so if you put a situation in place whereby you've got, I think it's close to 10%, I've been told, of the cars that have got this steering wheel on the right-hand side of the car rather than the left-hand side, which is obviously the safer, you're going to create an environment where people who are already uncertain are dealing with a situation which can be considered quite dangerous. So,
for the Papiamento speakers out there, be sure to stay tuned and continue watching ATV as Noticia Aonochi will have more coverage regarding the development of the potential new road law. Thanks for being with us. 15 on 15 will be back here tomorrow night starting at 7:15 p.m. right here on Channel 15. And once again, we will have another great lineup of topics, so don't miss it. We will see you then.